Hello everyone, Treecks here, and welcome back to Kirby's Dream Course once again. Yeah, we're still not done yet. We're still playing some Pink Kirby versus Yellow Kirby, Treecks versus Treecks. And Pink Kirby is still in the lead, once again. 3-2 now is. But we're still not done yet. We still have 3 more to do, so we can't really say too much about who is going to win this. And let's not forget about the true thing we're doing here, because this little contest is just to make it a little bit more interesting. What we're really doing here is covering these courses, so we can get to see how these courses work. And of course, see the courses in general. Okay. Adjust my headset a little bit, because I can't hear a damn thing. I know it doesn't really matter too much for the video itself, but it would be nice if I can hear the game. Okay, let's go. Let's first look at the course, of course. We've got a couple of hills with a lot of enemies everywhere. Yeah, this seems to be a doozy. The course itself is hard enough as it is, and they managed to put enemies in very awkward places. Once again, we're not in the extra courses for nothing. The time of things being easy is over. Oh, I managed to hit him. Did not count on that. Can't really use that, so come on. Nope. Oh, would be a good idea if I have my both of my controllers on my lap. I put away the P1 controller. Because if it isn't obvious, I'm not doing this with the same controller. You cannot control both of the Kirbys with one controller. There are a couple of games that do allow that option. That you can play with one controller and still have two players. But this is not one of them. Actually forced to do the yellow Kirby with a P2 controller. No other way around. But since I have two of them, and both of the players take their turns, they're never playing at the same time, with that I mean, it is pretty easy to just play a mode like this on your own. I've been doing that for years. I don't always have someone available to play this with me, so I sometimes decide to do it myself. This Let's Play included. But anyway, yeah. Yellow took this one. By a lot. Poor Pink. Is it once again going to be the moment Pink takes the lead, it is going to be equal again? The course right after that? No one has been able to get a lead of 2 so far. Let's see if that stays that way. Okay, this course we still know. But of course, like all of the other ones, enemies are placed very differently this time around. No longer enemies on top of these hills, but they are on the hills themselves. And the enemies in between are floating enemies this time. And a lot of spinning tiles everywhere. Looked like fun. Okay, first move. I am pretty sure I'm going to want to do this. Let's hope that spinning tile won't screw me. Would be nice if it doesn't. I could use my tornado to get a little bit of an extra bounce, or go over here. Because I could change my direction, of course, with this tornado. Let's first see how the shot goes, before I decide what I'm going to do after it. Well, first of all, I have no topspin. Oh, I was afraid of that. Oh, still got it. Thank you. Might as well go for you. Didn't work, though. Okay, Pink, this is your chance. For Pink, a topspin shot is going to be a lot easier, because spinning tiles have been taken out of the equation. Didn't want to go over that star. Come on. Ah. So annoying when that happens. Going right under a floating enemy. Okay. I bet here is to activate Tornado before I get the stone, so I can get anywhere. Not going to get very far, it seems. Nope. Okay, do I want to go for you first? Or you? I can try to go for both of them, but I'm not too sure about the direction here. Well, I didn't count on getting you, but I'll take it. Yellow is also moving now. Because of the spinning tiles being activated. Okay, these spinning tiles are annoying. I can't trust the bounce. So... this way I should be able to get in it. I have my rock, so I'm not too afraid about the speed. Thank you. I always keep calling stone rock. But you know what I mean. It's stone officially, I know. There we go. 4-3. I did not count on it happening, but apparently yellow took this one. Still. Okay, let's see if this one is a little bit easier to do. We have a switch right behind us. Green zone, sand pit, tornado, kaboo, random, arrow panel, couple of kaboos, and another random over here. And there's also enemies on top of here. Last time we started there, so it didn't matter too much then. But now it's going to be a little bit more annoying. I always have a neat little trick on this one. I've been using this one for years. And that is, try to go for this tornado guy and still get the direction to go towards that taboo. Taboo, come on, this is not Super Smash Bros. Brawl. And that is to do it like this. Make a little bit of a curved shot towards the bumpers. So that the moment you hit the tornado, the bumpers will fling you towards the kaboo. So you can continue your move. Pretty neat, huh? Been using that for years. Whoop. Might as well try. May never know. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be getting anywhere. I'm in a good little line for three of these enemies now, so... good luck, Pink. You have a pretty nasty move to do. How am I going to deal with this? Might as well go for this tornado. It will give me 4 points. 3 of them from yellow. And the 4th one from the tornado. Thank you. What's the best move Pink could do? Okay. Let's see if I can get 2 of you. Yeah, let's do it like this. And that won't help me. So this is where it ends. I can't get both of you. At least I'm pretty sure I can't. Might as well get you out of the way first. I do not feel like a floating enemy on the hill to be the cup. I do want to go for both of you. I'm going to do that. Never mind, there's not really too much I can do about that. Let's do this differently. Oh, this is going to suck. I already know this is going to fail. I love how yellow is still spinning around. Bam! Okay, yellow is really, 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 really far away now, so I declare the shot impossible. But at least let's see how close I can get, because I'm pretty sure Pink also can't make the shot. Yeah, this should work. I have tornado, so it should be a little bit more possible, but it still seems a really, really tricky shot. Ah. Okay, that was not really my intention. Couldn't really help that, because I was flying everywhere, so I didn't really have too much control. Should be doable. I'm out of health, but no matter. I'm getting in the cup, so I'm getting two back. 19-7. Man, already a 12-point lead. Barely even started. So far, Pink hasn't been able to do too much about it. Yeah, hitting that day and night switch wasn't really a good idea. But I did not do that deliberately. This looks fun. The UFOs are definitely the key to doing this one correctly fast. It's just a matter of getting there without wasting too many turns. Okay, thank you. Because that basically is, in a lot of cases, usually the downside of UFOs being present in these courses. Usually they're placed in such annoying, tricky to get spot, or simply very far away in the course, that usually if you're trying to go for them, asks for a lot of sacrifice. Yeah, it was worth a shot. Let's stop in front of him. So that's usually the downside of going for these UFOs. Sometimes they can be so annoying to get that you need to waste a lot of turns before you even reach that, and you have a risk of the other player already cleaning up most of the course before you even get the chance to... Seriously? Okay, I'll just do it like this. Not really the case in this course, though. The UFOs are not that far away, but trust me, that will happen in some courses where you can easily say that it is a pretty nasty business trying to go for the UFOs, even though they are very tempting because of making it easier to clean up the course quickly. But sometimes they're not really worth going for. In this case, it definitely was the case. It would have been nice if I had the same height as the random enemy, but apparently I did not. But this also works. No. In my defense, that was not an easy shot. Okay. Pink, you finish this. Yeah, he does have it. Loses the hole once again. Fourth hole in a row he loses. This is turning out to be a repeat of the Gordo course so far. Because of yellow taking every single hole so far. But at least Pink was the one to finish it this time, so he starts. UFO behind us, a couple of other floating enemies. And a couple of ability enemies over here. The boosters are still here, of course. They don't really have that much use this time, because we started the other side. Okay, it's obvious what I'm going to try to do first. You are mine. Let's see how much I can clean up. You can still grab. You. Yeah. There is a good little 7 points. It's something Pink definitely could use. I can't really do too much here. Might as well try to go to the right the moment I land, so I can try to go for the jump enemy. It's going to be hard to do. Ah, it was close, but no. Those kinds of shots are really hard to make if you don't have the guideline to tell you where you are going the moment you make hook shots. This one is easy. Oh, it would have helped if I had more. No, dang it. Well, Pink still takes the hole, so that's good for him, but did not want to have that backspin. But once again, that's basically the reason why I'm making this so hard for myself. Why I have the fast marker speed. So shots like that become a little bit easier to fail. We have a couple of enemies everywhere. Like always. And once again, there is a UFO present here. But it is the enemy that's hardest to get and furthest into the course. And therefore, probably not worth going for, like I explained a couple of holes ago. Oh, I get a nothing! Well, good thing that showed up at least once by this point. It is also possible to get no ability when you go through a random enemy. It doesn't it hasn't happened so far, but it is definitely a possibility, as you can see. Okay, Pink's option is reduced to only one. Namely, go up this hill, and I'm going to wheel myself up there. Like this? Hell yeah! Bye! Didn't think this through. I thought I was being smart. I did not realize that I did not have something to stop. Well, at least he got 3 points. Could have been only one or even zero if the shot failed completely. Let's get you. Like I said, UFO is not really worth going for. Take way too long to get up there. And even if you do, the course is probably cleaned up already by the other player the moment you do. Thank you. That's one more point for Pink. And he needs them, he's still behind 10 points. It's a long way up there. Even for yellow, because yellow also can't make this in one shot. First, let's get up that hill. Okay, next shot he should be in. Unless this guy can do something about that. Can also clean up some stars along the way. There's one. Didn't want to go up that high. Dang it. Once again, I did not mean to get that top spin in my shots, but there was nothing I could do about it. It was moving way too fast. This should be it. Yeah. Difference shrinks again. 9 points now. It's not a lot, but Pink is definitely creeping closer and closer. Should still be possible. If yellow is able to get an 8-1 in one of the courses, in theory Pink should also be able to do it. But yellow starts. We have a lot of arrow panels, enemies beside them, a little peninsula hill, if that's a word, and this annoying little freak over here. And the rest, yeah, the rest speaks for itself. The UFO is definitely a thorn in my side in this one. Because no matter how you look at things, this is always going to end up being annoying. If you're trying to go for the UFO, it is a hell trying to get up that hill. And even if you decide not to do it, the UFO is going to change into the cup. And you know what a cup means? That's also something you need to get yourself to. So, you're going to have to go up that hill no matter what, and it is really annoying to get up there. Needle is definitely required, I think. So, I'm going to pick that up with yellow. And let's see if Pink is able to survive the struggle. UFO, not worth getting, so change him into the cup. But it doesn't make it... Dang it, didn't want to hit that. Doesn't make it a lot easier, because now we need to get up this pretty large hill. Fly shots are useless here, even with top spin, so grounder and as high as possible, stop with needle. Pink can use his tornado. It's going to be a lot tougher. Ow. Pink is out. Okay, yellow takes this. And he's also going to take the course with that, because there's no way Pink's surviving this. First I need to make this, but even if I don't, pink does not have a chance anymore. This is over. Having the needle ability here is definitely the key. If you are the player who does not get the needle, it is hell getting up there. But the course is over. 12 point difference. There are no 12 stars to get in the final hole. Yellow once again equalizes the standings. Pretty funny little hole we have over here. A lot of air fence and enemies. A little bit the same as the original. There's Wispy in between now. And there's one enemy on top of the hill over here. Which is once again a pretty high hill. You can't really see it because of the perspective of the camera. But it is a really high hill. It's just as high as this hill we're on top of now. All of the hills are just as high. So that one too. Even though you can't really see how high it is because of the perspective. The hill itself falls out of view. But trust me, it's just as high. So it's once again going to be a little bit of a trouble getting up there. It usually also ends up becoming the cup, the final enemy on top of there. Whee! Whee! I always love the air fans with Tornado. You can jump so high with them. Whee! Hey, Yellow. Bye, Yellow. Well, this has been a long move. It's still going. Pink has already stopped, but now Yellow is the one who needs to stop. Okay, there we go. Let's see if we can get up there. I still have my needle, so it should be easy pickings. Pretty sure I can't make it in the first move. Well, I got up pretty high up, so I need to jump with pink. That's a lot tougher, but not impossible. Jump! Ooh! So close! Bye! Let's finish this. Pink is off screen. This final hole ends in a tie, and Yellow takes the course by a lot. 12 points. We finish this course with one of the players not being present on the course. 28 to 40. The standings are once again equal. Is this a trend that is going to continue until the end? If that is true, then pink should win the next one again, the Krakow course, and then yellow wins the extra Gordo course. Equalizing everything. Getting this little match with myself in a draw, that would be suiting. But it's not the case yet. Speaking of draws, a draw is of course also possible. It hasn't happened yet, it's pretty rare. That could also happen, would also make it a little bit nice. But anyway, I will continue tomorrow. See you then. Treecks out.